Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and heard the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 5th of June. Allies pledge support. PM Modi set to take oath for third time on June 8th. Experts say zero hope from Pakistan budget vows likely to rise. And Germany considers Afghan deportations after police stabbing. And now for all the details. A day after the election verdict, both Prime Minister Narendra Modi's BJP-led ruling alliance and Congress-led opposition Indy bloc held meetings to chalk out further course of political action. While PM Modi's allies pledged support for his historic third straight term, leaders from the opposition bloc have said they too will stake claim for forming government. A report.
A day after his BJP-led National Democratic Alliance secured a slim majority, Prime Minister Narendra Modi submitted his resignation to President Draupadi Murmu on Wednesday. Modi is set to take oath for a third straight term on June 8. On Wednesday, the coalition partners pledged support and held a meeting in New Delhi to chalk out further course of action. The ruling alliance secured 292 seats in the 543-member Lok Sabha, almost 60 seats less than what it got in 2019 general election. PM Modi's own BJP fell short of 32 seats from majority, unlike the last two terms, securing 240 seats. Earlier on Tuesday, PM Modi expressed gratitude to people for their support and said the government would write a new chapter of taking big decisions during its third term. Taking to X, he also conveyed thanks to world leaders who congratulated him for the third term in office and said he looks forward to work and extend global ties.
Hum Bharatiya milkar chalenge, desh ko aage badhayenge. Teesre karyakal mein desh bade faislon ka ek naya adhyay likhega.
Meanwhile, the opposition Indy Alliance also held a meeting late on Wednesday to decide their future strategies. The opposition bloc led by Congress improved their performance, bagging 233 seats. Improving its tally from last two terms, the Grand Old Party bagged 99 seats, with Gandhi Sayan retaining the family bastion of Rai Bareli. While the opposition alliance was way below the majority mark, a prominent ally, Uddhav Thackeray, exuded confidence in forming the government, while several other leaders attacked PM Modi over the poll result and demanded he should not continue in the top office as the mandate goes against him.
Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi ne 400 paar ka dawa kiya tha. Aur unke dawe ke hisab se 160 seaten kamayi hain. 240 seat unki aayi hai. तो प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी को नैतिकता के आधार पर इस्तीफा दे देना चाहिए कि देश की जनता ने उनको नकारा है.
And while in a gesture of diplomatic goodwill, Pakistan's Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif extended his heartfelt congratulations to PM Modi on securing a historic third term. Pakistanis have reflected a sense of tempered expectations. Many residents expressed their belief that the long-standing relations are unlikely to experience significant changes. Although they said Indians are better than Pakistanis as they are united. India and Pakistan blame each other for their frosty relations and often reiterate entrenched diplomatic positions on issues such as Kashmir and terrorism, suggesting no thaw-in ties is likely anytime soon.
Modi hoga ya koi bhi hoga. सारा एक जैसे हिंदू है ठीक है और है भी हमारा दुश्मन है क्यों खुश हो जाऊँ वरना फिलहाल फिर भी वो लोग हमारे से अच्छे हैं एक ही इतफाक है एक जैसे हैं चाहे कोई भी आ जाए पाकिस्तान लगता दुश्मन है
कहाँ पहुँच गए और हम लोग आज दिन तक वही 75 सालों से लेकिन आज दिन तक वही खेल खेल रहे हैं कि जी वो ऊपर चलेंगे और हम नीचे चले गए ठीक है तो बेहतर यही है कि जी मोदी हो चाहे जो मर्जी हो आपस में बैठ के बात करें अपने 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 मुल्क को सीधा करें अपने अपने गिरबानों में झांक लें तो मेरे ख्याल में ना बहुत ज़्यादा बेहतर हो जाएगा दोनों मुल्कों के लिए
Meanwhile, as Pakistan is set to announce its annual budget next week, experts have expressed there is not much hope of reduction in economic vows. A report.
Pakistan will present its annual budget on June 10, and markets are awaiting details of the plans seen as crucial to securing a new IMF loan. But experts say they do not have much hope. Instead, woes are likely to rise. Economic activity has been slow in Pakistan for the last 2 years, as it has been beset by inflation above 20% since May 2022, while it navigated reforms as part of a previous IMF bailout. And experts said the new budget will likely bring more price hikes and taxes.
Budget jo hota hai na, bunyadi taur pe ek relief ka naam hai. Budget jo tarakki ki taraf gamzan hone ka ek naam hai. Lekin hamari budget aati hai garib miskin aadmi ko mehngai ke upar. Aap dekhiye kitni mehngai badh gayi hai aur mehngai control nahi ho pa rahi. Varna ye to jo IMF pe ya kuch aur maliyati idaron ke kehne pe chal rahe hain to budget to control nahi karegi mehngai ko kyunki hamari policy koi achhi nahi rahi. Aaye din jo bhi ye mini budget dete rehte hain, aaye din ye mehngai karte rehte hain. Duniya mein petrol ka rate mehnga nahi sasta hota hai ya mehnga ho jata hai.
Earlier in May, in its half yearly report, Pakistan's central bank said the economy was grappling with structural bottlenecks, exacerbated by political uncertainty. Despite some improvement in macroeconomic indicators, it predicted real GDP growth of 2% to 3% for fiscal 2024.
Days after a policeman was killed in a knife attack by an Afghan immigrant in Germany, Berlin is considering deporting migrants from Afghanistan, who pose a security threat, back to their home country. Talking to reporters, Germany's Interior Minister Nancy Faeser said her ministry had been intensively looking at the issue for months and will take the decision as soon as possible. I'm also quite adamant that Germany's security interests clearly outweigh the interest of those affected, she said. The knife attack last Friday by a 25-year-old originally from Afghanistan severely injured 6 people and killed one at an anti-Islam event in Mannheim. The attacker, who was shot and wounded, was not living illegally in Germany. The opposition political party, AFD, has used the attack to call for a tougher migrant policy. However, such a move would be controversial as Germany does not repatriate people to countries where they are threatened with death. Notably, it stopped deportations to Afghanistan after the Taliban took power in 2021. Moreover, German Chancellor Olaf Scholz's Social Democrats coalition partner, the Greens, could also hamper the move as it opposes the plans for deportations to Afghanistan. Moving on. As many as 26 people have died and 41 others have been injured in Sri Lanka due to the inclement weather conditions, government officials have announced. Nearly 160,000 people were affected nationwide as heavy downpours have uprooted trees, downed power lines and cut electricity. The government has approved a proposal to rebuild houses that were completely destroyed, the president's office said. Schools in the island reopened, but some in badly affected cities such as Gampaha and Matara will remain shut until the situation improves. The highest amount of rainfall was recorded at 480 mm in central Sri Lanka, according to the weather office.
Irida Udepandra Ravasateka Udepandra Mivatura in the Patangata, Etekama Avata Kadavaloko Maskaragana, Minisu Arakshakatangulata Yanda Patangata, Adata Davastunai, Menota Patura Matama Adi Haya Hata Vinakang Gihila.
Bangladesh Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina on Tuesday said that new structures in Rohingya camps in Cox Bazar would not be wise as environmental and ecological imbalance has already emerged there due to massive deforestation for sheltering the forcibly displaced people from Myanmar. Hasina said that Bangladesh has given shelter to the Rohingyas on humanitarian ground as over 40,000 women were pregnant at that time. And that is why the government provided food and medical facilities by setting up field hospitals. She said that number of Rohingyas is increasing rapidly day by day due to the conservative mentality of Rohingya women as they are not interested to accept family planning. Bangladesh hosts more than 1.2 million Rohingya Muslims who over decades escaped death and persecution in neighboring Myanmar, especially during a military crackdown in 2017. Hundreds of locals from neighboring villages gathered in the village of Kalandari in India's Tamil Nadu state to celebrate a centuries-old fishing festival recently. Drone footage showed participants standing in the water setting fishing nets to catch fish. A local witnessing the festival for the first time said she was exhilarated to see such a huge number of people catching fish together and honoring the local custom. According to tradition, the fish caught during the festival is cooked and offered to the local deity with prayers for a prosperous harvest and good health for the villagers.
பிறந்தது இதே ஊர் தான் ஆனால் ஒரு தடவை கூட இந்த மீன்பிடி திருவிழா பார்த்ததில்லை இந்த தடவை தான் வந்திருக்கேன் மேரேஜ் ஆனக்கப்புறம் பார்க்குறதுக்காக ரொம்ப சந்தோஷமாக இருக்குது நான் இந்த மாதிரிலாம் பார்த்ததே கிடையாது இவ்வளோ பேர் மீன் பிடிச்சி எல்லாம் நல்லா கொண்டு போகிறத பார்க்க ரொம்ப ஆசையாக
இருக்குது That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night and take care.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.